Hey guys, how are you all doing? I'm Anketana Raj. I head the customer success team at SellerApp. We're very, very excited to announce the release of first in the market brand new feature called Path Insights as a part of the legendary PPC analyzer, especially to give insights for the new product targeting feature rolled out by Amazon. In the first part of the video, let's talk about product targeting, which you can find in sponsored product section for 3P sellers. And in the second part, let's talk about Path Insights and how you can use it to optimize your product targeting campaigns. So product targeting comes in twofold. One is automatic product targeting and the other is manual product targeting. So let's take a deep dive and figure out what these features do. Amazon has released four new match types in automatic product targeting: close match type, loose match type, substitutes, and complements. Close match type and loose match type are with respect to search terms. So when you enable close match type, it gives you visibility for search terms, or rather buyers who are looking directly for your product or the solutions that are offered by your product. So in other words, it matches the search terms that are typed in by buyers in the Amazon search bar to the keywords that you've used in your listing. So remember to optimize your keywords and the listing to the best possible limit. So remember, listing optimization and keyword optimization are the key to having increased conversions. So for example, if you were to sell a pet grooming glove, then you would get visibility for search terms such as pet grooming glove for cats, pet grooming glove for short hair, etc. So loose match type is exactly the opposite, where you get visibility for search terms that loosely match the keywords in your listing. So this helps in product discovery and brand awareness. In the long run, it can give you visibility to the audience who could be potentially interested in your product, which increases the conversions. So example, if you were to sell hair conditioner, then you would get visibility for search terms such as hair extensions, hair dryers, etc. Substitutes is another great way to get brand awareness and get visibility to the shoppers that are currently buying substitutes of your product. This is a great solution for new entries, and if you're selling a brand new solution that already doesn't exist in the market, then this would be the ideal choice for you. For example, if you're selling butter, you would get impressions for margarine. Compliments is an absolutely great way to drive traffic from new sources that you didn't have access to before. So you can drive traffic from products that complement your product. So let's say that you are selling hair conditioner, going back to our original example, then you'd get visibility for products like hair color, hair shampoo, etc. Let's talk about manual product targeting. Manual product targeting gives you a wider reach to audience and entire categories that keywords couldn't have fulfilled before. So this brings in a few advantages. For starters, you can target an entire category with just one click, and you can choose to get impressions for products that follow certain rules set by you. So the second advantage would be that you can choose to get impressions for products that complement your product, similar to the complement match type option that is available in automatic product targeting. But here you have the power to choose the products yourself. And the third advantage is that you can build brand awareness by showcasing your entire product line by targeting your own products. This will also ensure that your customers won't stray towards your competitors. Manual targeting has three different ways of targeting: categories, product names or ASINs, and brands. In category targeting, you can either select Amazon suggested categories, or you can specify the categories that you want to target yourself. Once you choose the categories, you can go nodes deeper into subcategories and select specific nodes that you want to target. To refine the targeting further, you can set criteria or rules based on price, ratings, and brand names so that you will be visible only to a subset of products within the specified subcategory. So once you set these rules, you can also see the number of products that will be targeted, and based on this number, you can either broaden up your rules or narrow it down. So let's take an example. If you were to sell a pack of batteries, you can literally choose as many categories as you want. For example, you can choose health and household, electronics, camera and photo, tools and home improvement, appliances, toys and games. Or if you were to go into subcategories, you can either choose complementary products, or you can choose products, top selling products in your own niche. For example, you can choose handheld flashlights, so you would have to go to tools and home improvement, safety and security, flashlights, and then handheld flashlights. So if you were to target top selling products in your own niche, then you'd have to choose health and household, household supplies, and household batteries. So over here you can click on refine to set rules based on price, review star ratings, and specify brand names. So this will show you the number of products that will be targeted based on the set rules. Based on this number, you can either broaden it up or narrow down your search. So instead of allowing Amazon to choose products that you get impressions for within the categories or subcategories that you have specified, you can choose the products that you want to get impressions for yourself. So manual product targeting gives you the second option to specify ASINs or product name. So let's take an example. Let's say you're selling diaper bags. You can either go to Amazon.com, type in diaper bags, and find out the top selling products in the niche, and copy the ASIN and specify that in the manual product targeting, or you can type in the product name and select a list of products that are suggested by Amazon. By selecting top ranking products or the products that seem to have a sponsored ad every time you check, you will be spending only a fraction of the amount of money that they will be spending to get the same amount of traffic. So for example, if you were to target a top level keyword such as diaper bags that would cost about $2 to $4, you would be spending only about 50 cents to $1 to target the top ranking product and get all the traffic to your product as well. But you have to ensure that you have a competitive advantage over the products that you're targeting. If not, you'll just end up draining money. But the silver lining here is that you get brand awareness. The flip side of product targeting is that you could be spending a lot of money on unwarranted clicks. As the target selection dilutes, so will the buying intent of the customers. So this could lead to high ACOS and wasteful spends. To mitigate the money bleed, Amazon provides an option to add negative brands and negative products so that you will not get any impressions for the specified products and brands. It is super critical that you analyze and optimize your product targeting campaigns, at least in the initial stages, when you don't know how the campaigns would perform given the wider reach. Now you can either head over to advertising reports, download the targeting report and analyze it manually, or you can head over to the super awesome Patent Sites in SellerApp PPC Analyzer and get actionable insights into your product targeting campaigns. So let's take a look at how to use PPC Analyzer Patent Sites to optimize your campaigns. First, you need to log into your SellerApp account, head over to PPC Analyzer in the left-hand menu and navigate to Patent Sites. Here you'll see three segments of keywords. So the first among the three is negative keywords. This extracts all of the keywords and ASINs that are essentially draining your money. You don't have to struggle with filters and spreadsheets. With just one click, you get to know all of the keywords that are bringing you zero ROI and wasting all of your money. So if you'd like to mark any of these keywords as negative, you can click here and it will instantly mark it as negative in your Seller Central account. Pat positive keywords is a list of all the keywords that are bringing you a lot of sales. So these are your sources of revenue, or in other words, these are your high ROI keywords. You can set the ACOS over here so that our smart algorithms will take it into consideration while giving you these insights. One of the most important metrics, along with sales and ROI, to measure performance of your campaigns and keywords is organic search visibility. It is essential that you track these keywords to find out which page you're ranking on and your search position on the Amazon search results. So you can track the keywords over here, and then once you start ranking on page one, it is not necessary that you keep advertising for these keywords anymore. Lastly, instead of going through hundreds and thousands of keywords and corresponding search terms, you can come to auto to manual to view a list of all the high ROI search terms from your automatic campaigns. You can select the campaigns and ad groups, click on move to manual to move these high ROI search terms to your manual campaigns to refine your target audience further. Yes, this check will ensure that the selected keywords will be added as negative exacts in your automatic campaign. In the next release, our proprietary algorithms will give you path suggestions where you can get insights into categories and products that have the highest probability of driving sales. You will also get suggestions for product range and ratings range based on high conversions, which considers factors such as competitive advantage of the product, niche profitability, and competition level, customer behavior, etc. These suggestions will include various success-proven strategies that have been well-tested and have always resulted in increased sales for our current customers. So you know exactly what to do. Head over to PPC Analyzer, Path Insights, and start optimizing your campaigns. Link to the free trial in the description below. Let us know what you think in the comment section. Subscribe to our YouTube channel for more great content. If you like this video, do give us a thumbs up and follow us on Facebook and Instagram. We'll be coming up with more great videos like this one very soon, so stay tuned.